Welcome to Analytics with Nags. In this video, I'm going to demonstrate how to publish your reports created in Power BI Desktop meant for Report Server into Power BI Report Server Online. Let's try to jump into demo without wasting time. If you're new to this channel, hit the subscribe button and press the bell icon for notification. Once I publish it, I will walk you through how the report server portal will look like, what are the different options available. In our upcoming videos, we will work mostly on the report server. Let's begin. We have a simple report that we have created in our previous session, and right now I'm going to publish it. So one of the option you can see here is like this publish is grayed out because I tried once when this is the report created in report server, and this has option to publish either in the cloud or we can publish to the report server. This is grayed out. This option is meant for online. So why it's grayed out? Before making this video, I have published this report for testing purpose, whether it's working fine or not, to the on-premise report server. That's why it is grayed out. Otherwise, it will be available for you if you are opening for the first time. So how we can publish? So there is an option here, save as, and you can click on Power BI report server. Then I mentioned earlier, it can be your report server name, the server name followed by the reports, however we configured in the report server configuration menu that we did in our previous video. So navigate to this path, then this is your URL, then you can click on just OK. So that's it. We are done with publishing the report. It is similar to how you will publish in your cloud. So it says take me there. Instead of take me there, I will walk you through how it looks like. So here it is. So you can see the localhost reports browser, and once you click refresh, we published just now, it will start appearing. That is the first dashboard. Let's click and launch and check this one. So now whatever we created in the desktop, you can see this report appears in our local website or the URL in the report server. And you can utilize this report and you can embed in your internal portal or SharePoint, whatever you want. So coming back to different options, let's try to see how we can configure this report in the Power BI report server. So right click on this, click on these three dots and go to manage. First things first, you need to ensure this database connectivity is fine. So you can see here, you can go for either Windows authentication or basic authentication. So just provide your username. In my case, I'm providing Nags. This dot is my local system. In your case, you can give the proper username. Then let me key in the password. Then just test connection, it is successful. Once it is done, you can do the scheduled refresh. So this scheduled refresh is nothing but you have created your report today with today's data as of today. From previous years till date, you have created it and published it. Once your development is done, your job is done. How the next day or the future dates data will be refreshed, that is the task of it. Once you published and configure your data source, once you schedule refresh it, every time it refreshes, it picks up the latest data from the source or where this Power BI is pointing to, then it will refresh your report. So you can configure the schedule refresh here. That we will take it later in part of other videos. Then you can configure the security. So this one, let me show you what is this customized security, other things a little later. Right now I want to show you other things. So this is only a configuration. The basic thing you need to ensure is like data source and schedule refresh. You can schedule refresh by the report level. That's it. Now coming back to the report server overview, it's a very simple option, very limited options that you will see here apart from what you see in the cloud version. So first thing you can create is the folder. So this you can compare with the workspace. So you can create a dedicated workspace, right? Similarly, you can create the folder to organize your reports. Let's say I want all my reports to be created in the sales folder. Then you can create the folder here. Similarly, you can have multiple folders to organize your reports. Let me create another folder name as CRM. And keep on, you can add it. This is for managing your reports. This is the first thing you can think of. And other things is like over here, whether it's you can manage, you know, we are opening report builder, you can build your reports from here. These options are not much used right now. We will not go deep into it. And the other way of uploading it, right? One of the option I showed you is here. You can save this report from file and save as. Once you save this report in some folder, then there is another way to upload. Let's upload in the sales folder. One second. So this is our another way of uploading. It's just this is the future you already aware. Like this exists in cloud as well or any other tools. From the report server you can upload also. In this way also you can publish your report. And this is something recently introduced where you want to move your or publish from your on-premise. You have all the reports over here. You decided you want to go to the cloud, right? So in that way you can use this option to publish. This is recently introduced, earlier it was not there. And apart from that, you can manage your security over here. Who and all going to be admin, who and all are going to be a viewer member role. So this is your management. Then you have a settings where you can have a subscription and site settings. This way I will talk about in detail in upcoming videos. So only very limited options available in the Power BI report server, where you can create folders and manage it, and you can upload from here. This is for publishing and this is to manage your access rights. I hope you understand what is the limitation over here. And you can see there is no two different things up here, one like a data set as well as your reports. Everything is a single report, so there is a huge contradiction between how you store your reports in the database and in the cloud as well as in the on-premise. When you publish your reports in the cloud, it will be stored as two separate files, right? One is separated by dataset, another by report. But when you see here, it will be a single report. There is no shared dataset concept. You cannot create, consider this as a dataset. You cannot create another report from this, okay? Each report is limited to single dataset only and the report itself. So there are a lot of discussions. You have may have a lot of questions. Once you start working on it, just try to post it in comments. I will try to answer as much as possible. We will see what are other options available in this report server as part of our upcoming videos. If you like this video, hit the thumbs up button and comment below for queries. Do remember that data is your asset.